Yeah, when people go, ew, I go, thank you. So, for those who don't know me, I'm Gigi Fast Elk Bannister. I have a background of a little bit of everything. I do unit production management. I do location scouting, location management. I have a full production company. I'm the president and CEO of Production Magic Incorporated. My husband is Reggie Bannister from Phantasm. We do a lot of work together where if they hire him to do a part in one of his movies, then a lot of times they'll hire me for special effects. They joke and say that I'm the queen of no budget, but it's because I solve problems. And a lot of the problems that are happening right now are with independent and startup filmmakers. There's no money. Okay? And the way we overcome that is by thinking outside of the box. A lot of young people that are coming out of some film schools are not trained to think for themselves. They're trained to use products that are already made for them. So a lot of times we have to create those products. So they finally refer to that as Cookie with Gigi. And with the market that is out there with high definition cameras are very unforgiving. They show every line, every edge, every crease. And so you have to be able to think, they do things like they'll change blood, stage blood, that you spit like 25 to 50 euros for, you know, a quart, a liter. It'll turn it pink or orange on the camera. It's because in manufacture, they're not accommodating the camera never lies. They're accommodating the human eye. The human eye sees it as red blood, the camera sees it as orange or blue, depending on how much yellow or blue they've mixed into the ingredients, okay? So when you start thinking in terms of what the camera wants to get what your personal tastes are up on the screen, and stop thinking about what the manufacturer wants, then you are ahead of the game. It doesn't matter what you're shooting with, okay? When we used 35 exclusively, 35 millimeter cameras exclusively, and you were raised through theatrical makeup, we learned about this, having to mix our own colors because of lighting, the difference in lightings when we were on stage and whatnot. Nowadays, we have cameras that correct for color. So if you have your camera on automatic correction, it doesn't matter what you do. It's going to be wrong. So if you can learn your equipment, as a makeup artist, you need to learn what the equipment does to your work. It's no longer sufficient enough to just know this craft. You must now know the camera's craft. You must now know the director's craft. You must now know what the producer wants, which is not to spend a lot of money. And that's where I come in. A lot of times, they'll go to, you know, if they've got the money, they have, well, in California, or in the States, we call it having a champagne taste on a beer budget. You want the Dom Perignon, Tom Savini, Greg Nicotero, like that, you can afford Gigi and draft beer. That's it. So the challenge then is to, and I'm seeing more of this, to generate a quality effect, but without having to use all the trappings of the big special effects houses and like that. Mr. Savini is one of my mentors. I used his work to get started. Watched what he did. Lon Chaney is another influence of mine. He didn't have a lot of fancy gear and stuff back there. He created his own. The number one thing about filmmaking these days, on video especially, is to learn how to make your own blood.